These are not illegal settlers. They are legal settlers. They've been there for a very long time.
For centuries.
Many years.
For centuries.
There are 12,000 of them. Not only that.
12,500.
But plus those who live off them, it could be 50,000. And over one person.
White men.
The question that, have we now gotten to a point of reversing the land reform where Pemat Tete Guriebu Kushurubi Kwatiruku Kabwama Tichi Bayufuti? We might as well go and tell say Sasabu Kinin. Kuti and I know good women each other disciple. Is that the message we should give? What is the cost of 12,000 people vis-a-vis one farmer? The government has enough farms to be able to give. The minister is embarking on the underutilization program, which can identify farms. So why don't we wait for that process to happen, identify, give to him? But we cannot afford to reverse the land reform, the gains of the struggle. The Indigenous Empowerment Act, you repealed it again. What are the people of Zimbabwe going to be left with when they live with that they have the land they don't have? So my question is very clear. They are not illegal. They are legal. So is it now going to be a standard measure for the whole country? Can we now go as members of parliament say, Kumaruwa kwa muruku, urumende kada shikakano, musawake inotora?
Good question.